Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel and please subscribe. Today our topic is the OSI model. Okay, so basically what is an OSI model? OSI model is known as the Open System Interconnection Model, and basically it is a conceptual model. What is the meaning of conceptual? That there is no physical existence, physical implementation of this OSI model. Basically, this is only used for the teaching purposes and to understand the networking deeply. So OSI model was developed by ISO. ISO is an organization which is used to standardize the technology. Basically, this is a global organization, and the OSI model divides the communication process, the networking process, into seven different layers or seven different steps of communication. Okay, and the OSI model was developed in 1978 to 1984. Okay, and the main reason behind the implementation of OSI model was that to standardize the networking technology, we have implemented the OSI model. Okay, if I talk about the vendor independency, so before implementation of OSI model, what was happened that, let us assume that there are two friends, one is Sam and Bob. They have same vendor of computers like Apple and Apple. So that could be easily able to forward the data in between them. The data could be easily forwarded in between them. But if I talk about the different vendor, there is one more friend named Harry. So the Bob cannot able to forward the data to Harry, because network was not standardized. So due to different vendors, the IBM PC could not able to forward the data to the Apple PC. So that was happened before the implementation of OSI model. So that is because of compatibility issue and software and hardware issues. So after implementation of OSI model, what has happened? We have standardized the network, and the Apple PC could able to forward the data to Apple as well as the IBM PCs. So that is the reason behind the implementation of OSI model. So in OSI model, we have introduced the seven different layers of networking. What? Seven different layers. And these layers are responsible for the transmission of data, right? So first layer is the application layer, second one is presentation layer, third one is session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. All the seven layers has their specific tasks to do. Okay, but the point to be noted is that the OSI model is only a reference model or a conceptual model that is only used to understand the networking technology. There is no physical implementation of this OSI model. Okay. Now, if I talk about the data flow in OSI model, how does the data flow works? Okay, if I want to forward the data from one PC to another PC, how it will be forwarded? The data will be generated from the application layer. Application layer will forward the data to the presentation layer, in which the encryption and decryption and compression of data will be done. After that, the session will open and terminate the session to forward the data. On transport layer, the segmentation will be done, as well as on the transport layer, the port number will also be added, right? And the next layer is network layer, that is providing the routing as well as the IP addressing. Okay. After that, the data will be forwarded to the data link layer, on which the encapsulation will be done, right? And after that, the data will be forwarded to the physical layer, and that the data will be converted into bit format. From physical layer of sender, the data will be forwarded to the physical layer of the receiver, and the reverse process of the sender will be done on this side, on the receiver side. So that is how the receiver will receive the data, right? So if I talk about the data format, application layer, on application layer, the data will be in form of PDU, On presentation layer, the data will be in form of what? PDU. On session layer, the data will also be in the form of PDU. Then the data slicing will be done on the transport layer. After the segmentation, the IP address will be added on the network layer, and then the MAC address will be added on the data link layer, and then the data will be converted into bit format, that is means the combination of 0 and 1. So dear all, this is all about the OSI model. Now we are going to deeply discuss about each and every single layer. So please watch more videos and subscribe my channel, and have a nice day.